welcome you to this day of remembrance, a day on which our Lord was crucified until dead and buried. Please follow along in your bulletin. There will be no further announcements, but please join me in the call to worship. Blessed be the name of the Lord our God,
who redeems us from sin and death,
for us and for the salvation of all. Christ became obedient unto death, even death on a cross.
Blessed be the name of the Lord.
And please join me as we read together the invocation. Holy and everlasting God, by the suffering and death of Jesus, you saved us from Adam's fall. Grant in your mercy that we may belong to a Christ lifted high on the cross, and by his redeeming love be raised to everlasting life with him, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit forever and ever. Amen. Hear the words of prophecy from the prophet Isaiah. Surely our griefs he himself bore, and our sorrows he carried. Yet we ourselves considered him stricken by God and afflicted. He was pierced through for our transgressions. He was crushed for our iniquities. The chastening for our well-being fell upon him, and by his scourging we are healed. All of us, like sheep, have gone astray. Each of us has turned to his own way. But the Lord has caused iniquity of us all to fall upon him. He was oppressed, and he was afflicted, yet he did not open his mouth. Like a lamb that is led to the slaughter, and like a sheep that is silent before the shearers, so he did not open his mouth. By oppression and judgment he was taken away, and as for this generation, who considered that he was cut off of the land of the living for the transgressions of my people? Summoned the chief priests and the rulers and the people and said to them, "You brought this man to me as one who incites the people to rebellion. And having examined him before you, I have found no guilt in this man regarding the charges you have made against him. Nor has Herod, for he sent him back to us, and nothing deserving of death has been done by him. I will therefore punish him and release him. Now Pilate was obliged to release to them one prisoner at the feast of the Passover. The people cried out all together, "Away with this man! Give us Barabbas!" Barabbas was one who had been thrown into prison for insurrection made in the city and for murder. Pilate, wanting to release Jesus, addressed them again. But they kept on calling out, "Crucify! Crucify him!" Pilate said to them the third time, "Why, what evil has this man done? I have found in him no guilt demanding death. I will therefore punish him and release him." But the crowd was insistent and with loud voices asking that he be crucified. And their voices began to prevail, and Pilate pronounced sentence that their demand should be granted, and he released the man they were asking for, who had been thrown into prison for insurrection and murder. But he released Jesus to their will.
Jesus.
Son, behold your mother. From the agony of the cross, Jesus remembers the welfare of his mother and gives her care to the disciple John. God, why have you forsaken me? Jesus is quoting from Psalm 22. The ending of that psalm is filled with victory. I thirst. The soldiers gave Jesus sour wine on a sponge to taste. I commit my spirit. And having said this, he breathed his last.
In the time of Jesus, when a worker had completed the assigned work of the day, he would say in Greek, "Tetelestai," it is finished. Jesus had completed the work that he came to do. Jesus died at 3 p.m.
time of the evening sacrifice for sin at the temple. At the time of his death, the curtain had separated the main temple from the Holy of Holies. It was torn from the top to the bottom, and direct access to forgiveness and the presence of God was made available to everyone. His death became the final sacrifice offered for the sins of all humankind. It remains only for the individual to accept the forgiveness offered and receive eternal life. And after these things, Joseph of Arimathea, being a disciple of Jesus, but a secret one for fear of the Jews, asked Pilate that he might take away the body of Jesus, and Pilate granted permission. Joseph came, therefore, and took away the body of Jesus. And Nicodemus, who had first come to Jesus by night, also came bringing a mixture of myrrh and aloes, about 100 pounds weight. In today's value, that would be between $150,000 and $200,000 worth of spices. And so they took the body of Jesus and bound it in linen wrappings with the spices, as was the burial custom of the Jews. Now in the place where he was crucified, there was a garden, and in the garden was a new tomb in which no one had been laid. Therefore, on account of the Jewish day of preparation for the Sabbath, because the tomb was nearby, they laid Jesus there.
Thank you.
receive now the benediction. Go now in silence and in contemplation to await the resurrection of our Lord. Amen.